very, very powerful, strong performance. I just spoke to the director and he said he was very emotional on days on set. Can you talk a little bit about that?
Yeah, there was, I feel like we were all going through the experience together, and sometimes it was incredibly emotional and other times it was just fun, you know, because there was a lot of extreme things that this family went through, and it wasn't always utter darkness, and it was, there was a lot of sense of adventure and good times as well. And I think being creative people, we've all come from our odd little families, and you know, those families have a powerful effect on you, sometimes good, sometimes bad. And so there was just something about this story that connected all of us, and we were able to have this cathartic experience together.
It's beautiful. It really is. You play a very strong survivor. In your real life, are you a fighter? What's the biggest thing you ever had to fight for? And you were like, I'm not backing down.
Well, I mean, I lost my father at an early age. Mm-hmm. And when I think about that, you know, looking back, that was a hard thing to go through. Yeah, I mean, it was my normal. It was hard, but that was the life I had, and so it sort of became a normal thing. But I think it instills a sense of survival instinct in you. Yeah.
Yeah. There was a lot of strong phrases in there. One, Rex was saying, "Learn by living; everything else is a lie." Now, in the world we live in today, can you relate to that a little bit? Would you say, actually, that's a pretty good phrase he said way back then?
Yeah, I mean, there was a lot of insight in both of these characters, these people, real people.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of integrity and a lot of bad behavior as well. But I think in the process, even with all these struggles that they went through, they did instill great values and great wisdom in their kids.
Yeah. One thing which was also really nice, when Rex gave his daughters the stars and planets for Christmas. If you look back to, you know, to your childhood, what was one Christmas present which sticks with you for the rest of your life?
I mean, you know, and you have to commend him for that incredible creative idea. I mean, what a fantastic thing to do. I remember, mine's not as special as that, but the first time I got a tape recorder, I remember just thinking this was the best thing ever. A tape recorder and a camera. Those two things were really fantastic.
People these days, they probably go like, tape recorder, what is that?
Yeah, I know, yeah, right.
Another thing what we learn in the story, it's like, you know, they keep getting up and running away and getting up and running away and hiding out. And sometimes it's easier, it always is easier to run away than face the facts. Are you personally a runner or a facer? I don't even know if that word exists.
No, I understand. I don't know. I mean, I definitely moved around a lot as a kid, and mm-hmm. so I'm drawn to adventure. I quite like that, but I do have a sensitivity to it. I think because I moved around a lot as a kid, I want to, you know, make sure that my kids are, but that's kind of just a reaction. I also want to make sure that they have, you know, lots of adventure in their life, because it did make for interesting times as well. So just to be able to balance the two things, I think, is important.
When did you lose your sense of adventure?
I have a little bit of money now. I can help you if you want.
Mm-mm-mm. We're fine. You're the one who needs help. Look at you. Your values are all confused.